Good evening and welcome to another trip report. Today I will be taking a very special train to Moscow from Berlin. Ostbahnhof is the streets. It's a train run by the Russian state-owned railway company RZD. And it's a Talgo train, which means it doesn't need a new wheels when it crosses the border with Russia. It has a unique wheel system. I will show you later on. Enjoy the video. For those of you that saw my previous trip report, knew that I arrived earlier today at Berlin Hauptbahnhof from the Netherlands. Berlin Hauptbahnhof is the biggest station of Berlin and serves more than 300,000 passengers each day. Roughly 1,800 trains do stop here daily. Because I wanted to see something of the city, I took an early train that morning, dropped my luggage at the luggage storage, and after I picked up my luggage, I took the S-Bahn from Berlin Hauptbahnhof to Berlin S-Bahnhof. These S-Bahn trains run very frequently and the journey time is about 10 minutes. Between 1987 and 1998, Berlin Ostbahnhof used to be called Berlin Hauptbahnhof. During the separation of both Germany and Berlin, this was the main station of the eastern half of Berlin. Since the opening of the new main station, Berlin Hauptbahnhof, the number of passengers serving this station have been decreased significantly. Still, lots of long-distance trains do stop here, and especially international trains that cross the border with Poland. Of course, you find many shops that will help to make your journey a little bit more comfortable, like a supermarket to grab some food, or a bookshop. As you can see here, my train is already listed on the departure screen. At the departure screen on the platform, there's also a layout of the train that indicates what carriage of the train will stop where at the platform, so you can stand right away at the right spot. Striets is the branded name for this train, and the Striets runs several times per day between Moscow and Nizhny Novgorod, and twice per week between Moscow and Berlin. Like I mentioned earlier, Striets trains are being served by Spanish-made Talgo trains. These trains do have a unique wheel arrangement. One set of wheels is shared between two carriages. I won't go in details too much, but this also creates a unique tilting system, so the train can take curves at a higher speed. The most unique thing about this set of wheels is that it is capable to change track gates. In Russia, the tracks are wider than in Western Europe with the standard gates. I will get back to this later. Because its capability to change track gauges, the journey time can be cut with about 3 hours, so you don't need a new wheel set at the Polish and Belarusian border. The journey time from Moscow to Berlin is about 23 hours, and the distance is a little more than 1800 kilometers. This train does have 4 comfort categories. The chairs you just saw are the lowest comfort category. This train is a very popular train. In general, it's fully booked, especially when you stay in a 4-berth sleeping compartment like I do. So when you want to take this train, book it early. You can book it 45 days prior departure. After the train has made its way to Frankfurt Oder, the border town between Poland and Germany, I went with some of the passengers that were staying on my carriage to the restaurant car. There we had a drink and a chat, and I could take a quick look at the menu. And I have to say, there's lots of choice in the menu. You can pay both in euros and rubles, and there's lots of food to choose from. In this train you get a free pair of slippers on your compartment, and there's a toothbrush included as well. It seems like I need some more practice by filming with one hand. The beds are already made, a small towel is included, there's one hanger per passenger, and every bed has their own reading light. I didn't take a shot of the entire compartment, but I'll be staying on a very similar train soon. When I have uploaded this trip report, I will link it up from here. There is some luggage space, because these trains are not very high, it was very limited. I would have expected a little bit more, and especially when you realize these are very long distance trains. There's also one power plug in a 4-berth sleeping compartment. From a modern train built in 2015, I would expect more. The table in the compartment also contains a sink. This is pretty unique on a 4-berth sleeping compartment. Above the window there's a small control panel, which can for example arrange the temperature in the cabin. The toilets in this train are very big. They also include a washing sink, and they were kept very clean during the ride. At each carriage you can tap cold and hot water for free. Well, hot water is not unique, especially not in Russian trains, but cold water is. You also find route information at the doors of the train, where you can see when the train will be where. Free Wi-Fi is provided on the train, although I tried to test it, but it didn't work for me. In the early morning, the train arrives at Tiraspol, the border town between Poland and Belarus at the Polish side of the border. After being checked by the European Union border control, the train continues its way to Belarus. Here you also find lots of container trains which probably will make the same route as I did, but the opposite direction. Well, there will be a lot more during these trips, so I promise you this won't be the first. This is also where I saw my first old-fashioned Soviet locks. Well, I filmed the entire route to the border, but no worries, I will speed it up a little for you. After this, the train made a stop at the station of Brest, where we were checked by the Belarusian customs. After immigration, the train is going to, well, as the conductor called it, the magic box. This is where the width of the wheels will be changed from standard gauge tracks like in Western Europe to broad gauge tracks like in former Soviet countries, so from 1435mm wide tracks to 1500mm wide tracks. I was really excited about this whole process and I thought I would notice anything, but you don't notice anything about this. What is pretty unique is that for old-fashioned trains this is a process of, well, maybe hours. But for this train, it's just a matter of a couple of minutes. Since it's still pretty early in the morning at this moment, and the train still has a long way to go, me and the passengers that were staying in my compartment decided to get some more sleep. I only woke up just before Minsk, and at the moment the train was arriving at Minsk, the capital of Belarus, I was having breakfast in the restaurant car. Normally the stop at Minsk takes about 15 minutes, but since there was a small delay, it only took 5 minutes. Well, there was still enough time to stretch the legs though. Like I mentioned earlier, this train does have 4 comfort categories. Private compartments with an ensuite shower, private compartments, 4 berth shared sleeping compartments, well, where I'm staying on, and the lowest category are the chairs. I will do a review of the chairs as well. Here you can see one of the private compartments, and also you can see they have their own key cards. So when you leave the room, you can just, well, it's like a hotel on wheels. This is a quick walkthrough of the train, but, well, this is a pretty long train, so I guess I need to speed things up again. Because this is a Talgo train, the length of the carriages is about half the size from a normal train. The restaurant compartment consists of 2 carriages. One part is only a restaurant, and the other part you find a kitchen and a bar. Right after the restaurant carriage, you find 2 seating carriages. Right after the seating carriages, you find the carriages with the 4 berth sleeping compartments. On all the doors of the compartments, both the 4 berth sleeping compartments and the private compartments, the destinations of the train have been mentioned. So, apart from the room number and the seat bed numbers, you also have a destination in your carriage where you can see where your apartment is. So, let's speed up a little. The train is being pulled by an electric locomotive, but gets power from big diesel generators that you can find in the first and the last carriage of the train. Although I personally wouldn't travel for such a long distance on a chair, I do have to say these chairs are pretty comfortable. Although it may seem a little different here, you do have lots of leg space, and I am a big boy. A fold-out table is located in your armrest. A At the end of the carriage there's some space for your luggage, but of course you have some luggage space in the overhead compartments as well. Just like in the rest of the train, you'll also find a free water point here, which includes hot and cold water. What is an advantage comparing to the forward sleeping compartment is that there are more power plugs available. There are no border controls between Belarus and Russia, so the train was in Russia before I knew it and making its way onto Moscow. Getting a little bit darker outside, the train is arriving in a bigger city area. It's obvious that Moscow City is not that far away anymore. I arrived at Moscow Belaruskaya bang on time. There was a delay along the way, but they catched up perfectly. I'll show you a bit of Moscow Belaruskaya. This might be handy when you do the trip the other way around. I'll show some more of Moscow stations in my next trip reports, that will be from Moscow to Samara. Just like many stations in Moscow, Moscow Belaruskaya is named after the direction where the trains do come from, so in this case Belarus. It's maybe not as big as other stations in Moscow, but it's still pretty okay. You have lots of shops where you can buy some food for your journey. And information is, well, I saw this on many Russian stations by the way, both in English and in Russian, of course. Even lots of train announcements are in English. Well, the last time I was here, it was in 2011, this was not the case, so many things have been changed and have been easier for foreigners to travel here by train. Of course you can also catch the metro from here. The metro of Moscow is just absolutely amazing. I spent an awful lot of time here because I wanted to see all these artworks and I still haven't seen enough. This is a station of Moscow Belaruskaya. So here I am, Moscow Belaruskaya. I arrived yesterday but I forgot to shoot some footage, so came back to shoot some more videos. I hope you liked this video. Please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel when you like to see more of these videos. Goodbye.